Good afternoon and welcome to our online class, economics class. So yesterday we constructed the multiple Butler diagram. Today I repeat this topic, how we construct the multiple Butler diagram. Multiple Butler diagram means what? When we construct the Butler diagram and which shows the two or more than two sets of numerical data. Okay, so here the question is, student marks in economics English. Student A, B, C have you see the board Devargho? Yes, write down this. Then we draw two axes, one vertical axis, one horizontal axis. Horizontal axis named by x, vertical axis named by y. This origin 0 and in vertical axis we here measure marks and here students. A, B, C. Multiple Butler diagram means what? Multiple Butler diagram means in one diagram we show the various information. Okay, in one diagram by using two or more than two bar we show the various information. Understood Devargho? What is the multiple Butler diagram? What is the multiple Butler diagram? Okay, then see. So marks in economics, student A got 40 marks. Okay, so first we draw for economics 40 marks, then for English 30 marks. This is for A. And for showing different subject, here we can use different color or different shade. So here I use different shade. Like this. Next one, student B who got the marks in economics 35. In English 15. Okay. For student C, okay, student C, he or she got the marks in economics 30. These two boxes, marks in economics, marks in English. So this is multiple bar diagram. Clear? Idea is clear about the multiple bar diagram? Devargo? Can I wrap this? Our next diagram is the subdivided bar diagram or component bar diagram. So, what is the concept of this component bar diagram? By the component bar diagram, we can show the total value of the data, okay. We can show the total value of the data. That means component bar diagram are those diagrams which simultaneously present total values as well as the part values of a set of data. First we show the part of the data, then we show the total values of data. Okay, let's see by one example. Estimate of cost. Okay, first write the question, then I will show how to construct the component bar diagram or subdivided bar diagram. Okay, Can I wrap this? Okay, first one is estimate of cost, A, B, C, D, then raw materials 50, for B 40, for C 45, for D 50, wages for A 40, B 40, C 40, D 40, fixed cost A 10, B 12, C 15, D 15, office expenses A 12, B 8, C 10, D 5. Okay, right. Have to draw two axes, one horizontal, another vertical, same. In horizontal axis we measured the cost and start from 0, 20, 40, 1 diagram. Okay, estimate cost, under estimate cost raw material, wages, fixed costs, office expenses, and for A raw materials 50, B 40, C 45, D 50, wages A 40, B 40, C 40, D 40, fixed cost A 10, B 12, C 15, D 15, office expenses A 10, B 8, C 10, D 5. So see, here for first one, raw material. Raw material first one 50. 50 means here. We find out the total raw materials for A, B, C, D. Okay, for A, B, C, D, we find out the total amount of raw materials for 50 for A. Next another 45, 45 means here this one is 50, 50 plus 45, 50 plus 40, 90, 90 means here, another 45, 135. Total 185. So like this we have to find out this one. Okay, so rest of the data you will do yourself at home. Try this, otherwise in the next class I will continue this one. Yes Devargo, can't understand. For A, raw materials how much? Cost of raw materials for A how much? 50. That's why we taken as, here we taken 20 scales, 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60. So 50 means between 40 to 60. Next for B, how much raw materials? Cost 40. Again 50 plus 40 means what? 90, below 100. Okay, next cost of C, 45, that means 135, below 140. Next 135 plus 50, 185. Just add it, nothing is there. Okay or not? Devargo, okay, so next day I will continue this. Okay, so for today I will stop here. Thank you.